This exercise is about the two aspects of light. Let's start with the phenomenon of diffraction. A source of monochromatic radiation with wavelength lambda in air illuminates under normal incidence a horizontal slit F of adjustable width A cut in an opaque screen P. A viewing screen E is placed parallel to P at a distance D whose value is 5 meters. For lambda, which is equal to 0.5 micrometers, show on a diagram the shape of the luminous beam emerging from the slit in the two following cases. In the first case, the width of the slit is taken as 2 centimeters, and in the second case, the width of the slit is taken as 0.4 millimeters.
For A equals 2 centimeters, since we have a visible light, and A much greater than 1 millimeter, so we do not observe diffraction, and the light obeys the principle of rectilinear propagation. In the second case, A equals 0.4 millimeters, and we have a visible light, so the emergent beam spreads out, and we have diffraction phenomenon.
Let's move to part 2. We use a slit with width 0.4 millimeters and we use radiation that falls within the range of visible spectrum, which is between 0.4 micrometers and 0.8 micrometers. The diffraction angles are small. Write in this case the expression giving the angular width alpha of the central bright fringe in terms of lambda and A. Look at the figure. This is alpha. It is the angular width of the central bright fringe, which is the angle through which the central bright fringe is seen from or through the slit. Now, we can write directly alpha as 2 lambda over A. Let's move to part B. Show that the linear width of the central fringe is given by L equals 2 lambda D over A. Now, look at the figure. If this angle is alpha, then this angle is alpha over 2. Now consider the right-angled triangle. Tangent alpha over 2 equals L over 2 over D, which is equal to L over 2D. But we have small diffraction angles. Then tangent alpha over 2 can be replaced by alpha over 2. Now, this is going to be L equals alpha times D. Now, replace alpha by 2 lambda over A. This is going to be L equals 2 lambda D over A.
Part C. Calculate the linear width L red corresponding to lambda red equals 0.8 micrometers and L violet corresponding to lambda violet equals 0.4 micrometers. We know that L equals 2 lambda d over a, so L red equals 2 lambda red d over a. Replace lambda red by 0.8 times 10 to the power minus 6 meters, d by 5 meters, and a by 0.4 times 10 to the power minus 3 meters. Therefore, L red equals 0.02 meters equals 2 centimeters. Similarly, L violet equals 2 lambda violet d over a, but lambda violet equals lambda red over 2. So we can write L violet equals L red over 2. Therefore, L violet equals 1 centimeter. Part D. We illuminate the slit with white light. We observe white light within the region corresponding to the central fringe of the violet light having a wavelength equals 0.4 micrometers. Justify. Since lambda violet is the shortest wavelength, then L violet is the shortest linear width relative to the other visible lights, as shown in this animation. So we can conclude that in this region, the central bright fringes of all visible lights superpose together. Therefore, we observe white light in this region.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to the phenomenon of photoelectric effect. A light source with wavelength 0.5 micrometers in air illuminates independently two metal plates, one composed of cesium and the other of zinc. The table below gives the values in electron volts of the work function W0 for various metals. Number 1. Calculate the energy of an incident photon of this light in joules and in electron volts. The energy of a photon is given by h nu, where h is Planck's constant and nu is the frequency of the incident photon, but the frequency equals c over lambda. Then, the energy of the photon equals hc over lambda. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of the energy of this photon, which is equal to 3.98 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Now we want to calculate this energy in electron volts. Observe, 1 electron volt equals 1.60 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Then, to calculate the energy of the photon in electron volts, we need to divide 3.98 times 10 to the power minus 19 by 1.60 times 10 to the power minus 19. Then, the energy of the photon is 2.49 electron volts.
Number 2. Which metal among cesium and zinc would experience photoelectric emission? Justify. Look at this table. The work function of cesium is 1.89 electron volts, which is less than the energy of one photon. That means cesium would experience photoelectric emission. The work function of zinc is 4.31 electron volts, which is greater than the energy of one photon. That means zinc would not experience photoelectric emission. Number 3. Calculate the maximum kinetic energy of an emitted electron. Using Einstein equation of photoelectric effect, E photons equals W0 plus Ke maximum. E photon and W0 and Ke maximum should be in the same unit. E photons equals 2.49 electron volts and W0 of cesium equals 1.89 electron volts. Therefore, Ke maximum equals 0.6 electron volts.
Let's move to part 4. The cesium plate is exposed to a monochromatic luminous beam with a wavelength of 0.500 micrometers in air and a power of 398 times 10 to the power minus 3 watts. The number of electrons emitted per second is then 1.00 times 10 power 16. Part A. Calculate the number n of photons received by the plate in 1 second. We know that the power of the incident beam equals the energy of the beam divided by time. The energy of the beam equals n times e photon. Rearrange. N equals p times t over e photon. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of n, which is equal to 1.00 times 10 to the power 18 photons. Part B. The quantum efficiency QE of the plate is the ratio of the number of the electrons emitted per second to the number of photons received by the plate per second. Calculate QE. Then, QE equals N over capital N. Now, N is the number of electrons emitted per second, which is equal to the number of effective photons, and capital N is the number of the incident photons. Then, the quantum efficiency is 1%.
Part C. The wave theory of light is used to interpret the phenomenon of diffraction. This theory failed to explain the phenomenon of photoelectric effect. Why? The failure of the wave theory of light can be attributed to 3 key factors. You can mention only one of them in your answer. First one, according to the wave model, as the light intensity or power incident on a metal increases, then electrons should be ejected with more kinetic energy. But according to the experimental result, the kinetic energy does not depend on the power or the intensity of the incident light. Actually, when the power increases, more electrons are liberated. Second, key factor. According to the wave model, if the light intensity or power is sufficiently high, electrons are liberated whatever the frequency of the incident light. But according to the experimental result, electrons are not liberated when the wavelength of the incident radiation is greater than the threshold wavelength, regardless of the light intensity.
The third key factor is that according to the wave model, at low light intensities, the photoelectrons need a measurable time interval to absorb energy before they acquire enough kinetic energy to escape from the metal. But according to the experimental results, the photoelectrons are emitted from the surface of the metal in less than 10 to the power minus 9 seconds, even at very low light intensities. Actually, the photoelectric emission is quasi-instantaneous.